Riff, today we are going to start our Unit 4 Reading A, What is Man Without the Beast? And knowing about the letter writing formats, informal and informal. Now open your textbook and look at the trigger page 66. This lesson is purely about our environment. When you look at a trigger page, the picture about the elephant, and he asks you to answer the questions that follow. You have watched this elephant picture. You can imagine what happened to the elephant in this picture. Now, what do you think the picture is about? I think the picture is about killing elephants to rob them of their valuable tusks. Some irresponsible people did. They don't hesitate to destroy nature for personal gains. We should love our environment, but in this picture you will be observing to rob their valuable tusks, they are killing the elephants. What can you do to save nature? I can be kind to animals, not only animals, and plants to save nature. I plant trees and love animals. I try to protect their life. See, when is our environment more beautiful? When we have plants, animals along with human beings, then our environment looks wonderful and beautiful. So these are the two answers about what do you think the picture is about and what can you do to save nature. You can write directly in the textbook itself those two answers. Now going with the page number 67, a very exciting lesson to us, what is man without the beast? It's an interrogative title to us. And at the end, we will know the answer for what is man without the beast. Come to the page number 70 about the speaker. Chief CRO, born 1786, passed away 1866. He was the leader of the Devanish and other Pacific Northwest tribes. The city of CRO, Washington, bears his name. In 1854, Chief CRO reluctantly agreed to sell tribal lands to the United States government and to move to government-established reservations. Though the authenticity of the speech has been challenged, most agree that it contains the substance and perspective of Chief CRO attitude towards nature and the white race. Now in this you will be observing the comparison to the human beings with the nature. Now how he is going to start? Now look at the page number 67, CRO's picture here. People choose different ways to protect the environment. Here is a speech delivered by a Red Indian Chief CRO more than a century ago to save his land. See, many people choose different ways to protect the environment. Now, here is a speech delivered by a Red Indian. Who is he? Our Chief CRO. More than how many years ago? A century ago. Why? He given a speech to save the land. Chief CRO became world famous for a moving speech he made in 1854, just before his lands were taken from him and his people. CRO's words resonate very well in the environmental community and are in fact considered to be something like a gospel of the Greens. Here, Chief CRO, when he given the speech, every person was motivated by the speech. And his speech became world famous for the moving, the way he had delivered about the environment. This was taken in 1854, just before his lands were taken from him. Sierra's words resonate, continue to have a powerful effect or value in the environmental community. In fact, considered to be something like it's a devotional gospel of the greens. How can you buy or sell the sky, the warmth of the land? The idea is strange to us. If we do not own the freshness of air and the sparkle of water, how can you buy them from us? The first itself is talking that how can you buy or sell? So it's not a land, it's not something. How can you buy or sell the sky, the warmth of the land? The idea is very strange. If we do not own the freshness of the air and sparkle of water, now how can we buy them? There is no opportunity for any person, because it's the gift given by the God, this wonderful nature. Every part of the earth is sacred to my people. Every shining pine needle, every sandy shore, every mist in the dark woods, every clear and humming insect are holy in the memory and experience of my people. The sap which courses through the trees carries the memory and experience of my people. The sap which courses through the trees carries the memories of the red man. By this we can understand the importance given to the nature here. It is a sacred to my people. What is sacred? Every part of the earth is sacred. When we start with shining pine needle, sandy shore, dark woods, humming insects, these are all are the holy and memory and experience of the people. The sap which is going to course through the trees, and also the sap which goes through the trees carries the memories of people as well as the memories of the red man. We are simple, we are a part of the earth, and it is a part of us. So we are all only the part of the earth. The perfume flowers are our sisters. The deer, the horse, the great eagle, these are our brothers. The rocky crest, the juices in the meadows, the body heat of the pony and the man all belong to the same family. So when the great chief in Washington sends word that he wishes to buy our land, he asks much of us. The great white chief sends word that he will reserve us a place so that we can live comfortably to ourselves. He will be our father and we will be his children. So we will consider your offer to buy land, but it will not be easy, for this land is sacred to us. Now who is asking? The great chief in Washington sends word. What is that word? He wished to buy the land. But what did he say? The perfume flowers are our sister. Usually, we will show the relation between the human being, our brother, our sister, our cousins. But in this, you will observe the flowers. Which flowers? Perfume scented flowers are our sisters. And the rest who are the brothers, the deer, the horse, the great eagle, these are our brothers. And next, going with our family, the rocky crest, juices in the meadows, the body heat of the pony and the man. All these are going to belong to same family. So when the great chief in Washington, when he sent a word that he wished to buy and he asked much, the great white chief sent word, not only buy, and he also sent a word, he will reserve a place so that we can live comfortably to ourselves. If you give your land to us, then automatically we'll make you comfortable. We'll give particular place to you. And he said, he will be our father. We all are the children to the Washington. So, we will consider your offer to buy land, but it will not be easy because the land is sacred. It's a holy place to everyone. How? The shining water that moves in streams and rivers is not just water, but the blood of our ancestors. If we sell you land, you must remember that it is the sacred blood of our ancestors. If we sell you land, you must remember that it is sacred, and you must teach your children that it is sacred, and that each ghostly reflection in the clear water of the lakes tell the events in the life of my people. The water's murmur is the voice of my father's father. Now he says that, don't look like a river. Don't look that the water is streaming. The shining water that moves in streams and rivers, it's not just water. We will treat that it is the blood of our ancestors. Persons in one family who lived a long time ago. They are called our ancestors. We never treat it as simple water. It is the blood of whom? Ancestors. If we sell you land, and you need to remember, it is the sacred blood of our ancestors. That is number one. Second, if we sell you land, you must remember that it is sacred, and teach whom? Your children, that it is a sacred, and that each ghostly reflection. Ghostly means looking or surrounding like a ghost. In the clear water of the lake, tells of events in the life of my people. The things which are happening in the life of the people, it is not that the experience, it looks in the ancestors. The water's murmur is the voice of my father's father. So this is a sacred place to us. The rivers of our brothers quench our thirst. Now, the rivers, already I said, they are considered as our brothers. Quench, satisfy our thirst. The rivers carry our canoes and feed our children. Canoe is nothing but a small, light, narrow boat pointed at both ends and moved using a paddle. And henceforth, starting from a particular time and at all times in the future, they feed, canoes are going to feed our children. Then if we sell you our land, remember to teach your children that the rivers are brothers, and yours, and you must henceforth give the rivers the kindness that you would give my brother. You should treat like the brothers, not simple as a river. Now precious, the air is precious to the red man, for all things share the same breath. The beast, the tree, the man, they all share the same breath. Breath is common to everyone. The air is precious to red man. So we all share the same breath. Who are they? The beast, the tree, the man. The white man does not seem to notice the air he breathes. Maybe the white man is not going to notice. Like a man dying for many days, he is numb to the stench. So that it is very valuable, precious. It's a very valuable and dear. Numb is nothing but unfeeling without sensation. It's a numb to our stench. But if we sell you our land, you must remember that the air is precious to us, that the air shares its spirit with all the life it supports. So it is sharing its spirit with all, ever and ever the air is common. The wind that gave our grandfather his first breath also receives his last sigh. And if we sell you our land, you must keep it apart and sacred as a place where even the white man can go to taste the wind that is sweetened by the meadow's flowers. Now here you'll observe, breath is common to everyone. Every living creature has the same breath on their lands. See, when we come on to the earth or when we are going to leave the earth, always the breath is common here. So here he is comparing that our grandfather has taken the same breath when he was landed. And also when he is going to pass away, he receives the same. And if we sell you the land, you have to keep it sacred as a place where even a white man can go to taste the wind that is sweetened. By whom it is sweetened? By the meadow flowers. What is called as meadow here? A field which is covered in grass. You will see the flowers, the fragrance of the flowers. You have to feel the same sweetness. So we will consider your offer to buy our land. If we decide to accept, I will make one condition. The white man must treat the beasts of this land as his brothers. Now I am going to consider your offer to buy our land. Now if you are going to accept it, there is one condition, that you people must treat the beasts of this land as your brothers. I am a savage and do not understand any other way. I have seen thousands of rotting buffaloes on the prairie left by the white man who shot them from a passing train. I am a savage and do not understand how the smoking iron horse can be made more important than the buffalo that you kill only to stay alive. I am a savage. Savage means a member of a people regarded as primitive and uncivilized. And prairie, you all know, in North America, a large open area of grassland. And I have seen, I do not understand any other way because I am a savage. And I have seen thousands of rotting buffaloes on the way on the prairie. What happened to them? They left by the white man who shot them from a passing train. Why did they kill the buffaloes? I am a savage and I do not understand how the smoking iron horse is called a pipe made of iron in a shape of a horse. It is a smoking pipe made of iron. So we call it as smoking iron horse. It is in the shape of a horse. It can be made more important than the buffalo you kill only to stay alive. So you are killing the buffaloes for the sake of the food. I have observed, I have seen. So what is man without the beast? If all the beasts were gone, man would die from a great loneliness of the spirit. So what happens when you are killing day by day many beasts? One fine day, a man suffers a loneliness of the spirit. For whatever happens to the beast soon happens to man. So today we are enjoying the food. Today we are killing the animals for our expenses or for something else. But one fine day we will be also in the same condition. And here all things are connected. It is a link. We think that is an animal, that is a bird. No, it is a link between ourselves. Now let's go to the respect. You must teach your children that the ground beneath their feet is the ashes of our grandfathers, so that they will respect the land. Tell your children that the earth is rich with the lives of our kin. Teach your children what we have taught our children, that the earth is our mother. Whatever befalls the earth befalls the sons of the earth. If men spit upon the ground, they spit upon themselves. See, something happens which has happened to somebody, but it definitely happens to us also. Today it did not happen to us, but tomorrow there is a chance that those things happen to the ourselves. So, in respect, what he says, teach your children. What we have to teach the children? ground beneath their feet is not simply a ground. It is the ashes of our grandfathers, so that they will respect the land. So it's a comparison with the relations. Tell your children that the earth is rich with the lives of our kin. What it is? Lives of your family and relations. So we have to treat. How to treat that? Ashes of our grandfathers. The earth is the ground beneath their feet is the ashes of the grandfathers. Respect the land. Tell your children that the earth is rich with the lives of our family members. Teach your children what we have taught our children. Now you should start teaching your children what we already taught about to our children. Earth is our mother. Whatever befalls the earth befalls the sons of the earth. See, befall. Befall is called as happen to somebody. If it befalls, if the men spit upon the ground, it is nothing but they spit upon themselves. So always think that befalls the sons of the earth. If men spit upon the ground, they spit upon themselves. This we know, the earth does not belong to man. The man belongs to the earth. All things are connected like the blood which unites one family. All things are connected. See how it is. It's a connection. Earth does not belong to man. Whatever befalls the earth, befalls the sons of the earth. If men spit upon the ground, they spit upon themselves. See, if we do something to others, immediately or after some time, the same things happen in our life also. So if you do something bad, again it happens to you. If you do something good, the good is going to happen. So whatever befalls the earth, it automatically befalls the sons of the earth. If today men spit upon the ground, they spit upon themselves. So we are not supposed to spit upon the ground. There are some restricted places. According to that, we should follow. This we know, the earth does not belong to man. Man belongs to the earth. We all know that. We come and we will be moving, but the earth is remained. So as we all know, earth does not belong to man. Man belongs to the earth. These are all the things are connected like the blood which unites one family. All things are connection. So today the environment is also the connection. Don't think that the blood, relations which we have, it is only the one of the connections in the human being. But the nature is also connection to us. Whatever befalls the earth, befalls the sons of the earth. Man did not weave the web of life, he is merely a strand in it. Whatever he does to the web, he does to himself. Already we have seen, whatever befalls the earth, befalls the sons of the earth in the previous paragraph. Now the same, man did not weave the web of the life. He is a strand in it. A single piece of thread or wire or hair, etc. He is simply just like a thread. Whatever he does to the web, he does to himself. If he is doing something harm, he is doing harm to himself. Now coming to the page number 70 continuation. Even the white man whose God walks and talks with him as a friend to a friend cannot be exempt from the common destiny. We may be brothers after all, we shall see. One thing we know, which the white man may one day discover, our God is the same God. The white man, they have a devotion of different gods, whose God walks or talks with him as a friend to a friend. It cannot be exempt for the common destiny. We may be brothers after all, we shall see. He wishes that the white and the red people should live in peace. A God is same to everyone. With the white man may one day discover that. Today he is not going to discover, but one fine day he is going to discover our God is the same God. You may think now that you own him as you wish to own your land, but you cannot. He is the God of man and his compassion is equal for the red man and the white. A strong feeling of sympathy and sadness for the suffering and also the luck of others and a desire to help them is called compassion. It is equal. It's a strong emotional feeling, sometimes happy, sometimes sad. Sufferings are common to everyone. The earth is precious to him and to harm the earth is to heap contempt on its creator. Heap contempt, do something against. Show the feeling that somebody is worthless. And here we can see that earth is precious and the harm the earth is to heap contempt on its creator. The white too shall pass perhaps sooner than all other tribes. But in your perishing, you will shine brightly, fired by the strength of the God who brought you to this land and for some special purpose gave you dominion over this land and over the red man. The destiny is a mystery to us, for we do not understand when the buffaloes are slaughtered, the wild horses tame, the secret corners of the forest heavy with the scent of many men, and the view of the ripe hills blotted by talking wives. Where is the thicket gone? Where is the eagle gone? The end of living and the beginning of survival. So, where is the blotted? Blotted, kept from being seen. It is concealed. The destiny of the people, the destiny of the nature is a mystery to us. We do not understand. Where are the buffaloes where they were slaughtered? The wild horses tamed. These are all which are going to happen. A talking wire is called as telephone wire. The secret corners of the forest with the scent of many people who are there. But always remember the end of the living and the beginning of our survival. Now this is a small, still there is a speech delivered by him. It's only a small part which was taken to us. So at the end what he is going to tell to people? The earth is precious. God does not like people who harm the earth created by him. So the nature, the environment is equal to God. We should not do any harm to our nature. So this is a speech delivered by him. Now here's the glossary. Read it well. And question and answers you can observe in your study material. Now let us go with the continuation of our study material. In this, he had given to us about the formal and informal letter examples. Page 179, letter writing, formal letters. First, we are going with the email format. So, electronic mail format. What is the use of this? The transmission of messages over communication network is called as our email. The advantages of email: less formal structure. It facilitates more paperless work. It enables the employers to function even without sitting at particular places like office, etc. It has transcended hierarchical barriers among the executives and employees. It is the cheapest means of communication. It is at present the fastest means of communication. It is kept as a secret and you can send the same message to as many people as you like. It is very convenient. You can read your message as per your convenience and sometimes we can correct our spelling mistakes when you are doing this email format. So format of an email is so simple. Here we are showing you in your study material, page number 179, one example of email format. See, in the box you need to write this. First start with to, next from, date, particular date, subject, reference and content. In content, we'll start with dear sir, to whom you are writing. Next, what you are wish to write there, you will be writing. So, in response to the reference cited, I wish to enroll myself as a data entry operator for your August office in Visakhapatnam. As for my qualifications, I completed my BSc with computers as one of my optional subjects, securing 93% of marks. I passed it with distinction. I worked for Sangam Enterprises for over 6 months. I was born on so and so date. I am of sound health and good physique. I am good at Telugu and English and have a working knowledge of Urdu. I enclose here with the photostat copies of my certificate. Please feel free to contact me for further information. In this connection, may I request you to enlighten me whether I would be eligible for house rent allowance over my basic pay or whether you would provide me free accommodation in case I am selected. Need I undergo any training, sir? And if so, how long and where? Say here, you are enrolling yourself as a data entry operator and you are explaining about your details. Finally, you end with a student signature. Who is writing this format? That person's signature should be written. See that you are maintaining in a box this format. The main importance are to, from, date, subject, reference and content. Next you will be writing about the information. Already many of them knows how to write a email. Now this is a format and explanation. Now next going to page number 180. First we will be going with the formal letter. Before going to letters, formal, there are two kinds. One is formal letter and informal letters. Formal letters means when you are going to write a business letters or invitation and excuse letters to those in authority. Editorial letters, those come under formal letters. And informal, friendly letters written to relatives and friends. So when you are going to write a formal letter, you have to, the address of the sender must be written on the top left side of the page, followed by the name and address of the person you are writing to. The second address should also be written on the envelope itself. The greeting is more formal in formal letters, like respected sir, dear Mr. or Mrs. The letter is brief and to the point, stating the matter clearly. The subscription varies with the greetings. The letter ends with your name and surname. Beginning and ending of formal letters, as we said, beginning dear sir, dear ma'am, whereas ending yours faithfully, yours sincerely. But whereas for editor letters, please mention truly. Now I am showing you the examples given on page 180, 181 and 182. The way of writing our letters. On page 180, seeking details regarding AMSET coaching. This is the model to write the to seek details regarding AMSET. Page 181. A post, a job of sales assistant. 182. Editorial letter format. These three please go through how to write a letter in formal ways. On page 183, you have two questions. Before reading the questions, now the newspaper report is below. On at the end of page 182, school children mobilize aid for cyclone victims. There is a matter given. Now imagine that you are the school leader who helped to organize the collection. Write your friend in Chennai telling him or her about how you went about organizing the collection. Second, imagine that you read the article in your newspaper. Write to the editor of the newspaper praising the work of the students and expressing your hope that more schools will follow this example. So, letter to the editor. 182 page, there is an example given to you how to write a letter to the editor. Station, date, and from address to address. Subject is mandatory and your content there. So, this is our formal letter. Now, going to the informal letter. In informal letter, there are some rules to follow. The heading or your address means do not write your name above the address. The date 27th September, etc. But writing the date as 27. so and so day, month and year is incorrect. Third point, the greetings, dear, my dear or my dearest. Fourth, the introduction or the first paragraph of the letter, 2 to 3 lines leading to the next paragraph. The body or the second and main paragraph of the letter, you answer the question given here. It is a descriptive paragraph, should be written in a natural style. The subject matter should be stated clearly and correctly. This paragraph can be divided into 2 or more paragraphs. The body can be 10 to 15 lines in length. The conclusion or the last paragraph of the letter in 3 to 4 lines. You end your letter here, write with a few lines about yourself, the family, etc. The subscription or signing off, your friend with love, etc. Your first name, not your surname. So, addressing the envelope, there are 2 ways of addressing the envelope. So, block style, indented style, here are the 2. And letter writing, one model I am showing you. Actually, we have 2 models to write. Now, this is one of the example of a friendly letter. Look at this example. This is one style of writing. And the second style of writing your letter is given to you on page 183. See, letter writing, your wish, any style. Either that style or this style. Option is reverse. Page number 183, it is clearly given. And 183 top A, imagine that you are a school leader who helped to organize the collection. Write to your friend in Chennai. After observing this format, then you start writing that option A question. Write a letter as asked below to your mother describing how you feel at your new college in a faraway town. To your principal seeking permission to open an English language club in your college. So one is formal, the other is the informal. After observing all the letter formats, then you start writing these answers. Turn your page to 184. Letter to the principal. Observe this. So, today we are going to complete our letters 183 and 184. So, write a letter to your mother describing how you feel at your new college in a far away town. The answer given on page 183. Second question, write a letter to your principal seeking permission to open an English language club in your college. That answer is given to you on page 184. So, go through all these formal, informal letters. Get well practiced with this format. It will be useful even for you for the 10th class also. In the next class, we will be completing the rest of the study material. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.